Hi everyone, Brian here at Sonnax. Today I want to share another innovative solution to a common problem transmission rebuilders face every day. Now this problem has to do with GM 6040 and 6070 transmissions. As you know, they're everywhere out there, millions all around the world, and just about everyone knows about 3-5 reverse drum failure problems in 2007 to 2009 model years. The main problem happens when the weak OE waved plate breaks and gets smashed all up against the drum like this here. It's kind of like silverware in a garbage disposal, leaving you with damaged splines just like this. Now GM tried to fix this problem in 2009 by making changes to both the wave plate and the piston, but we find the updated OE wave plates are still breaking. Whether in stock or rebuilt units, even Gen 2 units are not immune to this problem. So here at Sonnax, we studied the issue to determine the root cause, and we found a simple solution: an improved wave plate combined with a custom steel plate to set correct clutch clearance. It's called a drum saver kit because it not only prevents failure, it lets you restore normal operation even if you've got a damaged drum. And this completely eliminates worries about comebacks due to a broken OE wave plate. Of course, the early style wave plate always gets attention during a rebuild. Even if it hasn't broken yet, like this one, you know you can't risk leaving it in there. But you should also be thinking the same way even for units that already have the updated OE plate installed, because the cost of a failed wave plate and drum during your warranty period is just too high. These drums are not cheap, and neither is pulling the tranny out again, tearing it back down, and installing new parts all on your own dime. Now the waved plate in the Sonnax drum saver kit is shop pinned, just like the updated OE version, but we took the design a step further by eliminating virtually all fatigue points. See, that's the corner of the OE teeth right there. And on these broken plates, you can see that every single one broke off at a tooth corner. Even plates that look okay here can have microfractures and be on the verge of failure. But because we removed the teeth from the Sonnax wave plate, we're going to need a way to position it on the drum. And that's where the other part of the kit comes in: this custom cupped steel plate. This is a billet piece. You can see it's not a stamped plate. And these fit together perfectly. This is all you need to prevent failure or to salvage a drum that's been damaged like this one. Normally, this drum would have to be replaced. You can see the splines got all chewed up when the OE wave plate broke. But because there are no teeth on the Sonnax wave plate, there's no hang up. It can ride near the damaged area without interference. Cupped plate fits right over top. The cupped plate is the same thickness as the bottom steel in the clutch pack, so you can go ahead and throw that one out. This will give you perfect clearance every time without compromising heat dissipation. When I check clearance, it's right on, so I know I've restored normal operation. Now, as you can just saw here, this is so much faster and easier, not to mention less expensive, than buying a new drum and transferring the shaft and piston. So if you don't want to risk a comeback, this kit is great insurance, but now you can also quickly repair a failed unit. That makes Sonnax drum saver kits a great way to improve the reliability of all your 6040 and 6070 builds. So go ahead and ask your distributor for either of these kits, and please check out more of our parts for these units at sonnax.com.